Hello, I'm McCray Mizugano, an applications engineer in Texas Instruments' current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will show how to quickly set up and use the TMAG5273 EVM, which is an evaluation module, for the TMAG5273 I2C linear 3D Hall effect sensor. The TMAG5273 is a low-power linear Hall effect sensor with an I2C output interface with cyclic redundancy check. This device integrates three independent Hall effect sensors in X, Y, and Z axes, a precision analog signal chain, along with integrated 12-bit analog to digital converter, digitizes the measured analog magnetic field values. The device supports multiple power modes, including an active mode, sleep mode, and a wake-up and sleep mode that automatically alternates between these two modes based on a selectable time interval. The TMAG5273 can also be configured to enable any combination of magnetic axes and temperature measurements. Multiple sensor conversion schemes and I2C read frames help optimize throughput and accuracy. In addition, a dedicated INT pin can provide a magnetic threshold-based system interrupt during low-power wake-up and sleep mode, and can also be used by a microcontroller to trigger a new sensor conversion. An integrated angle calculation engine on the TMAG5273 provides full 360 degrees angular position information for both on-axis and off-axis angle measurement topologies. The angle calculation is performed using two user-selected magnetic axes. The device features magnetic gain and offset correction to mitigate the impact of system mechanical error sources on this angle error. EVM for this device includes the following features: GUI support to read and write device registers, as well as view and save measurement results, a 3D printed rotate and push module with embedded magnet to facilitate angle measurement evaluation with the TMAG5273, a detachable EVM for custom use cases, and it is conveniently powered from a common micro USB connector. The EVM kit comes with two PCBs, two standalone magnets, the 3D printed rotate and push module, which has an internal magnet, and a USB-A male to micro B cable. The first of two PCBs is the TMAG5273 EVM, which is shown in this picture. This PCB has two independent halves. The left half evaluates the A1 device variant of the TMAG5273, which has 40 and 80 millitesla sensitivity options, while the right half evaluates the A2 device variant, which has 133 and 266 millitesla sensitivity options. The two device variants on the board can be evaluated with the PCB intact as one unit, as shown in this picture, or can be split in half by gently flexing the panel at the red line in the picture so that there are separate boards for the TMAG5273A1 and TMAG5273A2 portions of the original board. The second board is the Sensor Controller Board, or SCB. The SCB, which communicates to your computer via USB, is connected to either the A1 part of the board or the A2 part of the board. To first evaluate the design, the PMB Windows USB drivers on the TMAG5273 EVM page must be installed by first clicking the download button shown below on the TMAG5273 EVM page. Make sure to run the downloaded .exe file as an administrator. This is a one-time only step per computer. After installing the drivers, the SCB can then be connected to either the A1 or A2 parts of the EVM, which will be shown in this video. For this video specifically, the EVM has been split into the A1 and A2 halves instead of leaving them as one PCB. Here we will show how to evaluate the A1 part of the board with the rotate and push module. To do this, we connect header J1A1 of the EVM to header J1 of the SCB, as shown here. We then connect the 3D printed rotate and push module to the A1 part of the EVM. To connect this, the prongs of the module are applied from underneath the EVM until they lock into the two holes. as shown here. Next, the SCB is connected to the PC using the micro USB cable. We connect one end to the SCB and the other end to the PC. This causes the green LED next to the USB receptacle to turn on as shown here. We are now ready to launch the GUI, which can be launched from the link in the user's guide or the link on the EVM page. After clicking on the link, click on the box that says TMAG5273 EVM GUI. Next, close out the dialog box that pops up. For the first time use, you may need to install additional drivers for the TI Cloud Agent installation. If these additional drivers are needed, the GUI screen will direct you how to install them. After completing these steps, confirm the SCB has connected properly. You will see hardware connected in the bottom left corner of the GUI interface to indicate that the SCB has been properly connected. If connected properly, click on the register map tab of the GUI. This page configures the register settings for the TMAG5273 device that is connected. For this demo, we will measure the magnetic flux density of the X and Y axes that are produced by the dielectric magnet that is integrated in the rotate and push module. To do this, we first click on the device config to register. Then we verify that the operating mode register bit says standby mode. In addition, we also verified that trigger mode says conversion start at I2C command bits. After verifying this, click on the sensor config 1 register and make sure that the X and Y channels are enabled in the MAGCHEN drop-down box. Next, click on the sensor config 2 register and set the XY range drop-down box to desired magnetic flux density range option. For the A1 device, option 1 selects the 40 millitesla range and option 2 selects the 80 millitesla range. If the A2 device was connected here instead of the A1 device, option 1 selects the 133 millitesla range and option 2 selects the 266 millitesla range. Since we are using the A1 device and the rotate and push module has a magnitude that is greater than 40 millitesla but less than 80 millitesla, option 2 is for the best full scale output range. As an optional step, set angle enable to X first, Y second. Performing this step enables the TMAG5273's angle measurement calculation. After these register settings have been made, go to the top of the register map and set auto read to as fast as possible. To view the angle at which the knob is turned, go to the rotate and push tab inside the plots page. As the knob is physically turned on the rotate and push module, the angle displayed on the dial and text below the dial would change accordingly. Here we will see that rotating the knob by about 90 degrees causes the displayed angle to change accordingly. In addition to viewing the results using the rotate and push tab, the results can also be viewed from the plots. This page shows the resulting X and Y channel waveforms, device angle measurement results, magnitude, as well as other plots. Another option to view the results is to look at the register map. Once you go to the register map, you can then look at the result register values and convert these values manually back into real-world units. After testing the A1 part of the EVM, the A2 can then be tested by first exiting the GUI. After exiting the GUI, the USB cable is then disconnected from the SCB. Next, the A1 part of the EVM is disconnected from the SCB as well as the rotate and push module. With everything disconnected, the A2 part of the EVM can then be connected to the SEB and rotate and push module following a similar procedure as shown before. As an alternative to the rotate and push module, this EVM can also be tested by bringing any of the two magnets that come in this EVM kit or your own magnet near the TMAG5273 EVM to observe the change in magnetic flux density reading. The small form factor of the EVM also enables integrating the EVM in your system for further testing. For more information on the capabilities of this EVM, please download the TMAG5273 EVM User's Guide. If you'd like to learn more about our Hall Effect sensor portfolio, please visit ti.com/Hall Effect to explore our technical resources and products.